Good morning, one and all. So, dear students, today we can be discuss about the diversity in living organism. Under that one, you can be study about the question answers section. So, first question: why do we classify organisms? So, because there are millions of species on this earth, for anybody it is impossible to study about each of them in his lifetime. Therefore, classification makes it easy to study the organisms on the basis of their certain common characteristics. Next, second question: give three examples of the range of variation that you see in life forms around you. Three examples of the range of variation in the life forms are ant, cockroach, spider, houseflies, etc. Living same building. So they are all belongs to the insect group, is it? So they look like entirely different from each other, and all of them belong to arthropoda. Humans, monkey, cat, and dog lives in the same neighborhood. They look entirely different, and all of them belong to mammalia group. And here we part, we show a wide variety of plants, right from small grass to giant banyan tree. So next question: which do you think is more basic characteristics for classification of living organism? The place where they live, the kind of cells they are made up of, why? So the kind of cells of an organism is made up is more basic characteristics of all classification of living organism, because it gives scientific angle of the classification. Moreover, a particular building place will be full of organism of a wide variety. Next question: what is the primary characteristics upon which first division of organism is made? Organism of nucleus is primary characteristics on which the first division of organism is made. Based on this, organism can be either prokaryotic or eukaryotic. Next question: on what basis are plants and animals out into different categories? We already know that plants are autotrophs, while animals are heterotrophs. Cell wall is present in plant cell, while it is absent in animal cells. Plants do not need to move from one place to another, while most of the animals need to move in search of food. Next question: which organisms are called primitive and how are they different from so-called advanced organisms? Answer: an organism which is simple is called primitive. On the other hand, an organism with high level of division of labor by formation of organs and organ system is called advanced. Next question: will advanced organism be the same as complex organisms? Why? Complexity in body design evolves because of the necessity to adapt according to the changing environment. Hence, complex organism would be an advanced one in comparison to the simple organism. Question: what is the predication of the classification of organism as belongs to the kingdom Monera? Testa. Organism which are prokaryotes belong to the kingdom Monera. Organism which are eukaryotes and unicellular belong to the kingdom Testa. Next question: in which kingdom will you place an organism which is single cell, eukaryotic and photosynthetic? The answer is: an organism which is single cell, eukaryotic and photosynthetic can be placed in the plant kingdom. Next question: in the hierarchy of classification, which grouping will have the smallest number of organisms with the maximum characteristics is common and which will have the largest number of organisms? Answer is: species. Species will have the smallest number of organisms with the maximum of characteristics in common. On the contrary, kingdom will have the largest number of organisms. Question: which division among plants has the simplest organism? Correct answer is Calophyta or Archaea as the simplest organisms. Next one: how are pteridophytes different from the phanerogams? Answer is: in pteridophytes, the reproductive organs are hidden and they do not produce seeds. In phanerogams, the reproductive organs are conspicuous and they produce seeds. Next question: how do gymnosperms and angiosperms differ from each other? The seeds which are naked in gymnosperms, while they are covered in angiosperms, gymnosperms do not bear flowers, while angiosperms are the bear flowers. Next question: how do polyphyletic animals differ from the ciliated animals? In polyphyleta, body has numerous pores. Next question. How do annelid anecas different from arthropods? We know that anecates have a segmented body while loose segmentation is absent in arthropods. Arthropods are jointed appendages which are absent in annelids. Next question. What are the differences between amphibians and reptiles? We already know that amphibians need water to lay eggs and fertilization take place externally. Reptiles do not need water to lay eggs and fertilization take place internally. Next question. Next one. Amphibians use both skin and lungs for breathing. Reptilians breathe through lungs only. Next question. What are the differences between animals belonging to the apes group and those in the mammalian group? In apes, body is covered with feathers, while in mammals, body is covered with hairs. Mammary glands are absent in apes, while it is present in mammals. Next point, four limbs of apes are modified into wings, which is not in case of the mammals. Apes are the oviparous, while most of mammals are viviparous. Next question. What are the advantages of classification of living organisms? Because there are millions of species on this earth, for anybody it is impossible to study about each of them in his lifetime. So classification makes it easy to study the organism on the basis of certain common characteristics. Next one. How do you choose the between two characteristics to be studied for the used for developing hierarchy in classification? The answer is, we need to look at the fact if given characteristics is present in a small number of organisms or a large number of organisms. In the first case, the commonality of characters would represent the species. In the latter case, the commonality of the characters would present in a higher taxa like genus, family, order or phylum. Next question. Explain the basis for grouping organisms into five kingdoms. So, following points explain the basis of the grouping of the five kingdoms. First one is organization of the nucleus. Organisms with unorganized nucleus are kept under kingdom Monera. Those with organized nucleus are kept in the other kingdoms. So, next point, number of cells. Unicellular eukaryotes are kept in kingdom Protista, while multicellular eukaryotes are kept in other kingdoms. Next one. Mode of nutrition and presence of cell wall. Heterotrophic organism in which cell wall is present or taken under the kingdom fungi. Autotrophic organism in which cell wall is present or taken in the kingdom plantaria. Organism in which cell wall is absent or taken in the kingdom animalia. What are the major divisions in plantaria? What is the basis for these divisions? The major division of plantaria and the basis for these divisions are thallophyte, bryophyte, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and last epithelicales are angiosperms. So thallophyte means it is a simply body design with no differentiation into root, stem and leaves. Bryophyta means it is the body is differentiated into stem and leaf like structure where there is a vascular system is. Next, in case of pteridophyta, body is differentiated into root, stem and leaves. Vascular system is present. So this group is further classified based on the seeds of naked or enclosed in the fruits, namely. So first one is gymnosperms, another one is the angiosperms. So gymnosperms are seeds of naked, angiosperms means seeds are covered. Next question. How are the criteria for deciding division in plants different from the criteria for deciding the subgroup among animals? In the plant kingdom, morphological characters are taken into consideration while deciding about the divisions. Morphology is the study of shape and forms of various parts. In the animal kingdom, anatomical characters are taken into consideration while deciding about the subgroups. Anatomy is the study of various organs designing animals. Next question. Explain how animals in vertebrates are classified into further subgroups. So we know that in vertebrates we are classified into further subgroup is five groups. One is Pisces. In Pisces, the body is streamlined, muscular tail is present, which assists in locomotion.
Body is covered with scales. Pale gills are present, which can breathe oxygen dissolved in water. They are cold blooded. The heart has only two chambers. Then they gills. Next, tetrapoda. Animals have four limbs for locomotion. Hence, the name is called tetrapoda. Tetra means four. Tetrapoda is divided into four classes, namely amphibia, reptilia, apes, and mammals. So, under this one, first one is amphibia. These animals are adapted by both in land and water. So, they secrete the mucus glands on the skin if the skin is moist. The animals breathe through skin within water and through lungs when on the land. The heart has three chambers. They are cold-blooded animals. Example is frog, toad, salamander. Next one, reptilia. Those animals show crawling movement for locomotion. Skin is harder to form scales. Most of the reptilians have a three-chambered heart, but crocodile has a four-chambered heart. They don't need water to lay eggs. Rather, eggs are covered with a hard shells and they are land. So, this example means snakes, lizard, crocodile, turtle, etc. So, next one is apes. Here, the body is covered in feathers. The four limbs are modified into wings. These are warm-blooded animals. The heart has four chambers. The bones are hollow, means pneumatic, which assist in flying. All the birds belong to this class. Next, last one is mammalia. The body is covered in eight skin has sweat glands, and sebaceous glands. So, mammalian glands are present in females and are used for nourishing the young ones. Most of the mammalian gives birth to young ones and are called viviparous. Some of the mammals lay eggs and are called oviparous. So, for example, humans, chimpanzees, lion, platypus, ours, etc. So, objective type of questions we can study about here. So, first one, chloroplast in spirogyra is spirally arranged and ribbon shaped with phenoids, spirally arranged without phenoids, circular cup shape. So, chloroplast in spirogyra means it is a spirally arranged and ribbon shaped phenoids. Next, needle shaped structure in pinus plantis, leaf, shoot, stem, stamen, reproductive part. So, needle shaped structure in pinus means it is a leaf. Next one, which among the following produce seeds? Therophyta, bryophyte, pteridophyta, gymnosperms. The correct answer is gymnosperms. Next one, which of the following are called amphibians of plant kingdom? So the correct answer is bryophyta, algae, pteridophytes, and gymnosperms. The answer should be bryophytes. Next question, a plant which has woody stem and its leaves show reticulate pination is gymnosperms, monocot, dicot, and pteridophyte. The correct answer is dicot. Next one, fill in the mess. Fungi shows dash mode of nutrition. So, fungi shows the saprophytic mode of nutrition. Cell wall of fungi is made up of dash, chitin. So, the correct answer is cell wall of fungi is made up of chitin. Next one, association between blue-green algae and fungi is called dash. So, that is answer is lichens. Next one, chemical nature of chitin. So, which is made up of chitin is, it is made up of carbohydrates. Next question, dash is the smallest number of organism with maximum number of similar characteristics. The correct answer is species. Name one basic characteristics for all the classification of living organism means, the basic characteristics for all the classification means based on the cell structure. Next one, what was the modification introduced by the Carl Linnaeus in Kingdom Monera? Carl Linnaeus modified the Kingdom Monera by dividing it into Archaeobacteria and Eubacteria. Why fungi got saprophytes? Because fungi consume decaying organic material as food and are therefore called saprophytes. Next one, what is evolution? Evolution means the life forms with that exist today have risen because of changes in their body design over the course of time to adapt themselves to change in the conditions. So this is, you can record as the evolution. So in other words, you can record as the, it is a formation of the complex simple organism to the complex organism. Next one, what are corals? Corals means they are the marine or you can call it the ocean forms. Disintegrate the tribe in the colonies finally attached to the rocks, hence it is called as the corals. Next question, prawn, housefly, spider, they are belong to one group. So name the group, justify the name given to the this group. So prawn, housefly, spider means they are all called as the arthropoda groups. So why it is called as the this group means they are the jointed legs, hence arthro means jointed legs. Next question, what is mean by warm-blooded and cold-blooded animals? So almost we can regard as the Pisces, amphibians, reptiles, these are all called as the cold-blooded animals. Birds and mammals, these are all called as the warm-blooded animals. Here, warm-blooded animals means they have a relatively high blood temperature and can maintain the constant internal body temperature through the metabolic process. Yes, mammals and birds are always you can regard as the warm-blooded animals. Cold-blooded animals means we can regard as the reptiles, amphibians, fishes, which are continuously change their body temperature with change in the temperature of the environment. Next question, why do we keep the both snake and turtle in the same class? Because they are also crawling animals, is it? So snake and turtle are the cold-blooded animals. They are belong to the same class because they have the scales as a outer covering. Both have the breathing. They can use it for the lungs for breathing. They have to the three chambered heart, they lay the eggs, tough outer covering, all these reasons we can be snake and turtle in the same class. Next question, which organisms are called primitive? Primitive organisms are those which have the ancient body design and have not changed very much with their passage of time. That is, we can be called as the primitive organisms. So next one, what is binomial nomenclature? Binomial means two. So it is the kind of naming of the scientific name of organism with a two component, that is one is genus, another one is the species, that is you can refer as the binomial nomenclature. Next question, explain the silent features of phylum Mollusca. So there are four types that you can give one. First one, they are aquatic and terrestrial. They have unsegmented and soft body. Foot is used for the locomotion, respiration by pair of gills. Next question, give the general conditions of the phylum Porifera. So Porifera means those are the holes or pores that is all over the body, that is you can be called as the poriferas. They are multicellular, they are also aquatic and mostly marine. The body cells are arranged in the two layers. The inner layers have the flagellated corpuscles. They have the nervous system and organs which are not present in their the skeletal system of the spicules. Canal system is present both the for present for the circulation of water. So there is the larva is serrated, reproduce both sexually and asexually. So here drawing the earthworm and label the parts given. Last question, how do the non-chordate are different from the chordate animals? Non-chordate means do not have the notochord and are also called invertebrate. Other name of the non-chordate means invertebrates. Central nervous system, CNS is solid and ventral heart is dorsal if present. Hemoglobin is dissolved in the plasma. They are the post-anatomy is absent. So chordate means you can cards of vertebrates, they have a notochord in the initial of life. A tubular nerve cord and pharyngeal gills are also present. So generally central nervous system is shallow and dorsal heart is always ventral. Hemoglobin is present in red blood corpuscles. Thyroid present is post anatomy. Next last question, give the difference between monocord and dicots. So monocot means seeds which contain only one cotyledons. The leaves have the parallel lineation. They have the fibrous root system is formed. No secondary growth you can see in the monocot. Flowers are usually tetramerous. Next one is dicots. So here seeds contain two cotyledons. Leaves have branched bag-like lineation. Taproot system is formed. Secondary growth occurs. flowers are usually pentamerous.
So these are the some question answer session we can be study about here. So thank you and all.